is brought to you in living color.
Y'all ready for this?
Here we come.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Hell yeah, yo.
Little bit of heaven, 94.7. Can he be? Really?
KHJ
Pirate Radio
KFXM.
Always do. Good morning, Roy and Jimmy in the morning here on chaoticradio.com. This is Roy Brewster, and this is...
I am Jimmy Shaw. It is Monday morning. It's chaoticradio.com. It's Roy and Jimmy in the morning with the lovely Donna Main.
Good morning. Happy Monday.
It's Monday already.
Oh, woohoo! Yes.
As Donna said before we went on the air, oh, that was a quick week.
It's a quick week, yeah.
All of a sudden, we are sitting here again.
I know, and it's the day after Mother's Day. Where are the mimosas?
You spoiled yourself. Cocktails in the morning.
Yeah, that's my favorite. They call it mimosa, cocktail in the morning.
I could do, my morning cocktail is a Bloody Mary. That would be...
Yeah, that's good, too.
We should have one of those continental... We'll call it a continental breakfast morning show.
Yeah.
Have a couple cocktails, just some croissants.
Croissant.
Right?
Croissant.
Those stale-ass ones at the hotels for the continental breakfast.
Yeah.
Yeah. Lay that buffet down.
What is it? The American Airport Inn over here? Or what is it? The little hot spot we found for a while.
Where you're making something. Your world-famous waffles?
The waffles.
It was making waffles every day.
Every day, man. They're going to give you a waffle?
Roy, we're going to be late. No, I'm just pressing the waffles.
And it's cool. You got to, like, press your own. You pour the right amount in that little paper cup out of the big old jug.
I think he just had more fun making them than eating them.
Well, the cool thing is you did the waffle, and you're in a hurry. If you made yourself two waffles, then you put some stuff in the middle like banana and peanut butter, and it's a sandwich.
A waffle sandwich for Roy.
That sounds good.
Hey, they're going to give it up. We're going to do it, right?
Yeah.
This is too early for breakfast talk. I'm so hungry now.
I could always eat something, but I'm not real hungry this morning.
Not a big breakfast guy. If I have a huge breakfast in the morning, I'm done for the day.
Yeah, no, I can't do that.
And I have to eat the whole day. If I have like the eggs, the bacon, and all that, then I need a snack in a couple hours. I need lunch, more snacks, dinner. But if I don't, I can do like a big lunch and be good for like the whole day.
Yeah.
And be fine with something in between.
Yeah, and we're talking about big lunch for Jimmy. We're talking about big lunch.
We talk big.
Yeah.
We're talking big. I'm the guy, when I go to like fast food, I have to go inside because it keeps me in check. If I'm in the drive-thru, I still start picking everything.
Oh, my goodness.
Two of those. Let me just have five of these. I got one more and a large fry.
A few bags.
Yeah, then I have like three, four bags when I go home. I'm like, okay, you're about to be impressed, people.
Don makes fun of me at the drive-thru because I'll go, I'll have this and like a burrito and a taco and then nacho and a churro and that's it.
And then that's it.
I always finish it with that's it. What is that? But I do finish with that's it.
Pretty much one of everything, and that's it. I'm on a diet. Yeah. I'm good.
Yeah.
And a Diet Coke.
I don't know. I don't think it's I don't think it's that I say that's it. It's how I throw it in there.
Right.
It's like, and it's always, and a double down, that's it.
And that's for yourself. That's not for
them. Anyone else.
That's you just saying, that's it. Stop it, Roy.
And I know they make fun of me about it, but but I still do. I can't stop. Can't stop, won't stop.
Hashtag drive-thru.
Oh, wow.
It's Roy and Jimmy in the morning. It is chaoticradio.com. It is... Something's playing. Here we go. Take two.
Okay.
Take two. Roy and Jimmy in the morning, chaoticradio.com. Roy, Jimmy, Donna, we are coming back at you. Give us a call, 909-360-8330.
Welcome back to Roy and Jimmy in the Morning here on chaoticradio.com.
You have that down so smooth. I listened to our morning replay yesterday, and I'm just fumbling on this Roy and Jimmy thing.
It just cracks me up that you were the one, not beating up, just like, dude, it's the wrong one. I'm like, yeah, now it's just, I'm locked.
I'm like, be a professional, Roy, for crying out loud.
And then what's going to happen, we're going to go late, and I'm going to go, Roy and Jimmy
in the Morning at night. Sometimes.
Roy in the morning, Jimmy in the evening, Jimmy in supper time. How's it going?
Yeah, that's perfect. That's because we're all over this station. We are Monday night.
Are we really?
There it is.
Are we?
There it is.
Just checking.
There it is. Okay, so we are Monday mornings, obviously, and Tuesday mornings, 7 to 9 a.m. live. And we have our show on Tuesday night, 8 to 10.
Yes. Replay Sunday.
Replay Monday nights, 5 to 6.
Oh, sorry. I jumped the gun.
Thursday replay, 6 to 8. And then the original, can't top it, Chaotic and Coffee, Sunday replay. Mm. And all those time slots are brought to you by the lovely and talented artisans at Kudos Pizzeria. One convenient location north of Ontario Mills, right there on the corner. In beautiful Rancho Cucamonga / Ontario, right there. Right there.
Yeah, across the street, you're there.
Across the street. It's Rancho Cucamonga and it's Kudos.
You know, you said Chaotic and Coffee. I just smelled the dark roast.
Didn't it just waft on through?
A little bacon. No. Oh, I sound like Stephanie all of a sudden making a pizza.
We have cheese.
Cheese.
Then we put more cheese.
For the love of cheese.
And then we're going to put cheese on it. And then a layer of cheese.
I saw her the other day.
One more layer. Hang on, Roy.
And then you have
another layer.
A cheese.
This is for you, Evan.
And then you have a shot of, I don't know what it is, because you're going to be locked up from the cheese. Got to the floor.
Locked up.
What is that stuff called? Stuff you take.
Epica?
No, that's to throw up. No, you don't want to throw up.
Well, that's going
to
unlock you.
That's going to lock you the wrong way. What's the name of that stuff? Oh, my goodness.
Milk of magnesia.
There you go. There you go.
A little Pepto-Bismol.
Let's talk to the one who knows.
Milk of magnesia.
A doctor's orders, please.
Shoot it off on the side. Yeah. Woo!
Yes. We're going to hit you up with a little weather now. See how this weird week is going, because every week is a different weather situation going on. Last week we're in the hundreds. We had shorts, tank tops.
Yep.
Sweating to the oldies. Yeah. That'd be them watching us sweating to the oldies.
Uh-huh.
But now we had rain at the end of the week. Now we got a nice mild day, so a little more weather. Here is Donna Main.
Oh, thank you so much. Now, we had a special request. Apparently, we have a big fan base now in Langford, South Dakota.
Yeah.
It is currently 58 degrees and raining in Langford, but the high today will be 75. Interesting. Hmm. It'll be very similar to Rancho Cucamonga, actually, the high. In Los Angeles right now, it is 58 degrees and sunny. Awesome. The high will be 69 today.
Very 69.
Yes. And we're going to look at Sedona, Arizona. Sedona, Arizona. 58 degrees and sunny right now. High of 79. That sounds like a lovely day in Arizona.
That is.
Yes. And I'm going to look at, of course, the one and only Cut and Shoot, Texas. You know them. You love them. It is 76 degrees right now. Partly cloudy. But Cut and Shoot is going to go up to 91 degrees today.
Cut and Shoot is so far, they're always the higher temperature.
A little bit.
Yeah. It climbs.
So that might be like they call Oklahoma the Dust Bowl. That might be the heat bowl right there.
It is a
heat
bowl.
In the old flyover state right there.
So it's 90, going to be what?
It's going to be 91 today.
91. Feel like temperature is hell.
It'll be
the hot bowl.
Yeah.
The hot box.
A hot bowl.
I don't know.
That's why. The hot box. Speaking of, that'd be the hot box is the annual tournament for cornhole. It'll be not the Super Bowl, but the hot box.
Is that going to be held in Cut and Shoot?
Cut and Shoot, Texas. Yeah, the hot box right there.
Jeez. That was good.
We're waking up. I like that one a lot, actually.
And Roy, you got a little traffic for everybody here. We did have already a preview of traffic.
Of course. We had a call in from Commander Matt. talking about the traffic this morning.
Yeah.
Let me pull. You know what? I'm going to do it. I'm going to pull it up exactly as it was said.
The actual verbatim live traffic report.
This was after our song to wake you up. Says, I've got an effing slow ride for you. 91 West is hell. other traffic news for you this morning. Oh, now I went across it. 210 westbound, starting to back up right around Day Creek. Speeds down to 29 miles an hour. Slowing all the way down to about 25, sitting around Haven. Starts to open up, speed up, fly across until you get into Azusa. Around Citrus, you're down to 15. 60 freeway westbound, back normal backup starting at Reservoir. Speeds down to 19 miles an hour. 91 west, Commander Matt handled that for us. And 71 freeway southbound, right as you hit, what do you think? Euclid Avenue, hitting that 91 mess. Speeds are down to 11 miles an hour. And that is your traffic update for the 8 o'clock hour.
Mess. Thank God they have us.
Yeah, right.
For this morning mess.
Just reported, just because. Just popped up.
Oh, fire back up.
Wreck has been moved to the 91 freeway. Uh-huh. East, it's Central. Just reported a wreck moved. So right there at Arlington Avenue, forget it, 12 miles an hour. I mean, just popped up right now.
Still so double digits, though. Yeah. I mean, I think that's the only thing we've learned in the last few weeks of doing this morning show. As long as you're in double digits, you're hauling ass.
For the morning. That's what you're doing.
For the morning.
Depending on the size of us, some are hauling more ass than others.
Because you got to keep yourself in check. I'll be coming home from work, and we're doing 75, 80 with everybody else, and it drops down to 55, 60, and you're like, this is bullshit. No, you could be doing 12.
Yeah.
That, you could be.
Yeah, you could be doing 12. You slow down to 45, 50, you're like, I'll never get there.
Yeah.
I'll
but
never
I don't know
there.
How many times I've jumped in there, and you're actually doing zero.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I've had that.
That happens a lot.
The parking lot.
Yep. Yes, the parking lot. And that's usually a Sunday afternoon when no one should be doing that.
It's all odd times.
You can't just say, you know,
day or night.
You can't pick that day anymore or that time of the day to go, you know what, we'll go when the traffic's light.
There is no such thing.
No.
No such thing anymore.
Jimmy.
Yes, sir.
We're burning gas in a helicopter.
Yeah, the
sorry. I was waiting. We're kind of hovering.
No, we were, but I just thought about it.
Where did we land?
Any last minutes? Any last minute?
No, because we got to put that thing on the ground.
All right, yeah, because, you know.
We're gonna burn, we only get budget, it up like four times a show.
The budget's tight, so we have to bring this thing down.
If you'd like to sponsor the Roy and Jimmy thing, like our beautiful people at Kudos Pizzeria, please give us a call. Hit us up on social media.
We'll throw your name on the traffic copy.
I got a sign business. Wrap it if you want to buy it.
We'll wrap it.
Wrap the copter. That's something I didn't think about. I got to go hit all the copter people. Maybe wrap the copter.
The chaotic radio, Kudos Pizzeria, traffic helicopter. We can put 5-6 more logos on that thing.
Yeah.
That's not a problem.
No, we'll do it.
That's not a problem for us. And we have no shame about it. We'll do it.
I'll do it now.
We'll do it.
Surprisingly, no shame.
But surprisingly, no shame. Not at all.
I felt that a little bit.
We have chaotic radio time is 7:22. If you got anything you want to talk about your weekend, it was Mother's Day yesterday. Got anything to share on that? It's 909-360-8330.
What do you think of that?
That is the chaotic radio. Roy and Jimmy in the morning. Donna Main Hotline.
Wow. All
right. That's a mouthful, but I have no
official.
Problem.
Sounds
I have no problem with
official.
These long titles because we are officially the Jack of All Nerds presents chaoticradio.com, home of Roy and Jimmy in the morning. You see I did there.
I adjusted nice.
It.
Very nice.
You did it.
And here's our shameless plug from Evan. Orange Show this Saturday, $15 per person, 2 for $25, free parking NASCAR K&N West Series. 57 lap late model race, street stock, and barber pole. That's Saturday.
Got your barber pole.
What is this?
Okay.
All right.
You got hot box and Roy's running now.
Yeah.
You know, I'm going to get a text and a thing here in a minute again. Roy Frank.
Roy Frank, what is your problem?
I got it from both sides.
We got to give our little shout out here for watching our pre-show thing. We got my mama saying good morning because it was her day yesterday. Again, happy Mother's Day to my mom. Ariana, Evan, and we have some likes here. I just don't see them right here. Here we go. We got our good fan base here. We got Roy Brewster.
Yeah.
Cousin Nikki, our buddy Deirdre, David Hughes, and the coolest name I've seen all week, Elvis Guthrie.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, Elvis. Yeah. Anyone who named their kid Elvis has got to be the coolest shit ever. Mm-hmm. Elvis
yeah,
Smith.
Yeah, there are
Elvis
a few...
Sanchez. Elvis anything yeah. is badass.
I've met a few Elvi in my lifetime.
That's they call her. But...
a group of them are Elvi. Because yeah, you can't yeah. say Elvises.
That's what they tell everyone.
Yeah, you can't say that.
Yeah, you're safe when you meet an Elvis, but if you you meet two or more Elvi...
Elvi,
you really yeah. need to watch your back. we pluraled out the Elvises.
Elvis, I want to thank you for watching. Thank you very much.
Thank yeah. you very much. Elvi.
You know what? He's probably so tired of hearing that. Sorry, we just lost him. He came in to check it out. Anyway, these guys just
yeah,
jacked with me again.
It.
Yeah, Elvi.
yeah.
We like made, cacti we and octopi?
Yes. Cacti...
What octopi.
Is that real?
Yeah, octopi is real, I think. It's not octopuses.
yeah, people say that.
But
yeah.
it's octopi.
I saw well, a bunch we, of yeah, I saw a bunch of octopuses.
I had this discussion about Prius cars. We say Prii instead of Priuses.
Yeah.
Prii? Yeah.
It's true cuz it's yeah, just yeah. not good on the tongue.
No, it's not.
It doesn't flow.
Yeah. yeah.
Well, it's like if you had a group of apes, they were shrewd. They are a shrewdness.
A shrewdness?
Yes.
Wow. A shrewdness of apes? Yeah. Is that?
Yes.
Really?
That's yeah.
Like a, I don't a think murder I've heard of, that.
What is that? Who's
oh,
murder?
Crows.
A murder of penguins
crows.
Or something?
Crows, yeah. Crows.
Murder of crows, yeah.
Yeah.
yeah. A badger is a seat.
A seat C-E-T-E. Of badger.
C-E-T.
Hmm.
A bat sounds good because it's kind of Halloween-y. Is a cauldron of bats.
Ooh.
Ooh.
Ah! Yeah. Cauldron, yes.
Right?
Yes. Eye of Newt. Yes. Yeah. Cauldron of bat. Yes.
How about a bear?
A cub of bear? No, no. It's a baby.
No.
it's odd. I never heard this. I never heard shrewdness either. But
no.
You're a
sloth?
A
sloth? Or a sleuth?
But a sloth is an animal.
I know.
Yeah.
So the sloth's going, hey, man. Got so, my cred.
Deal. That's our deal.
I got my I got my street cred.
We want to be a sloth of sloth.
Of bears?
Yeah. I got a sloth of bears in my backyard.
Is that two or more or three or more? Does it define that?
No, it just says a group.
Okay.
A gang. A gang or a obstinacy. So we'll go with gang.
What?
Obstinacy.
That's a bad word.
Yeah. Oh, that does not roll.
This one is.
Roll
so we're gonna use gang. Buffalo. What do you got out in the field? I got a gang of buffalo.
I
want Don to say that on Fremont Street.
Absolutely.
Absolutely.
You're probably gonna nail that word too. Hammered. Just flows. It's easy, guys. Absolutely.
How about cats? Is it clouder or a pounce?
What?
Or a glaring? For kittens, it's a Kindle or a litter or intrigue.
A Kindle? That's cute. A Kindle?
A Kindle of kitties.
I got a Kindle of kitties.
Yes.
A Kindle of kitties.
Same,
yes.
Yeah, same letter start, same letter other.
Wow.
Yeah, okay, that's fine.
Yeah.
But why do cats get so many?
So dogs is a litter. We know of puppies.
Right.
A pack in the wild.
Uh-huh.
Or a cowardice.
I haven't heard that one.
They were bored at the...
It must be very old English. Yeah. I don't know.
They must have been bored at the name the animal factory.
No, we got a lot of them here.
Is this like at a comedy show, a crowd is three or more people?
Yeah, that's a crowd.
not the shows we were supposed to play. you mean a bringer crowd?
Oh, I like elk.
Oh, yeah.
Elk. What do you got over there? What do you got over there? How many elks you got over there? I got a gang of elk.
A gang of elk.
I got a whole gang full of elk over there.
Standing there all rolling hard.
Like going, what's up?
So,
give me that.
Yeah, they all have different signs, right?
Out.
Yeah.
Only one sign, two hooves.
Ferrets are a business of ferrets.
A business?
A ferret's giving you the business.
A business.
I just want to be all firm.
I
got me a business.
Business of ferrets.
I got a business of ferrets back here. Want to know what the fuck is going on.
That's what it is.
Yes, that's firm. That is very
aggressive. That sounds serious. Aggressive. Yeah, like that.
That's aggressive.
A parade. Who's a parade?
Flamingos. It's a bird.
I love a parade.
I don't know.
It's a bird thing, right?
Elephants. A parade of elephants.
Of course. Cute. Of course.
Right?
You got the little tails and the trunks all hooked together.
Together going around?
Yes.
What if you're in the back and the elephant in the front has a little problem?
I don't think elephants worry about that. They're like, this is a normal day.
Yeah, I would if you, I mean, you catch one of them big old shit knockers on your tusk.
Shit knockers. And I always think elephants even got their own theme song. I love it. Let's hear it. Let's just sit here.
It is.
Let me go to mute.
It's gotta be.
Sorry, mute.
That's all right. Well, I was going to do the next one, but I really want
to. I like the build-up, the suspense.
There it is. There they go. Whoa. Here comes your parade of elephants.
That's so cool.
They got their own little thing. It's all elephant right there.
You don't hear a dog song like that.
Not a dog song.
I can see a big fat ass elephant walking around.
And they're all just going down the road.
Big old feet. Look like buckets.
And even if a married elephant couple, even if they got mad, this is their walkout song. I'm out of here, lady. It's got no seriousness to it at all.
So it's funny, an ape was one, and gorilla has their own.
I should try that next time I get in a fight and just like play this song as my out. This is bullshit. I'm out of here.
It makes you happy.
It does.
It's like, oh, what an asshole. But man, that is a great song. Yeah. It just makes you smile. All right, I'll see you later. Go blow your steam off.
Hippopotamuses is a bloat or a thunder. A bloat or a thunder?
A bloat is rude. We already know we got a situation.
Hey, why are they so damn big and float around and got ears the size of, should be in a rat?
When they wiggle, it's so cute.
They're cute.
Who built that thing?
It's a puzzle. You ever see that puzzle pieces put together?
Ever seen that one video? I'm pretty sure it was a hippopotamus when they're at the zoo, and someone was filming them, and the hippopotamus let off some gas.
Yeah.
You ever see that video?
I don't think so.
So funny. All of a sudden, it starts going, and chunks are flying, and the tail's wagging. It's freaking hilarious.
Here we go. Hippo fart explosion.
Yeah, did you see it?
No, I just pulled it up.
It came up, though, right?
Yeah.
Oh, so funny.
All right, hippo butt explosion. All right, here we go.
It's so funny. All right. You got to play this so we can hear it. Listen to this thing. That's what you call him, a bloat or a thunder. It's hilarious, too.
What was that? Megan, did you see that?
All right, come here, Donnie. You gotta see.
You gotta get over. You
gotta see the
tail is wabbing. Ready to go and start it? Hey. That's why they're called a bloat or a thunder.
That is the definition of when the shit hits the fan right there.
It goes on for like 10 minutes.
He is just clearing out.
He's got the tail going as a rudder, trying to get it all mixed up.
Oh, man, that is something to see, but then you get a little jealous going, you've had those days when you just go out in the middle of nowhere and just blow it out your ass. Instead of holding it all day. You know what? I just need to go blast this thing.
Oh,
nature is a beautiful thing.
There's no shame except with us humans. We're like, you know what? How do you feel? I'm a little bloated.
That guy didn't care.
I gotta go.
He was feeling so good after that. Yeah. You can just tell.
20 pounds lighter. He can think clearly now. It's just all good.
And you know, you saw the tail going. You know, the ears were going.
Yeah, we had the little front. He probably had his eyes all rolled back. Like,
my goodness!
He's just like, this is the best day ever.
Best day ever. Oh, it made me laugh.
Oh, that's fantastic.
Oh my God, that was great. Nature.
I told you it's good.
Nature's the best.
We can start our week now. That's.
I'm going to live vicariously through that moment right there. Right. That just made my day right there. I'm going to have like a little fart I'm going to hold so my girlfriend doesn't hear it. But this guy's just... they're taking pictures. I don't care.
Imagine me right before I went, hey! get your camera ready. Got some shit coming.
That'd be like our morning ritual before we go on air. All right, everybody ready? Clear? Let's go.
We'll get Donna in here about five after. Like, no, I'm good.
Yeah, got Donna calling her friends for backup. Yeah.
That is glorious, but I'll join you in a few minutes.
She'll fast. We'll see how it goes with you guys.
Maybe laugh.
Oh, man.
Okay.
Well, see, Matt could do it right now because he's in his car all by himself. He's probably loving that, going, yeah, that's a great idea. Just got a leg up in his big old truck.
What was that? What was that? Jake break.
That was just my horn. Just my horn.
Oh, boy. Boy, this show.
Mark just, Matt just freaking farting, just blowing the horn.
As he lifts up off the seat.
As he lifts up off the seat, higher elevation.
That is very elevating, yes.
Oh, that was a good one, Roy. Good opener. Good opener.
Hey, I just happened to see it.
Hippo blowing ass chunks. That's a great opener.
My favorite part, I hope people on YouTube saw it, was your reaction was the best.
Oh, man. Yeah. Like, I'm backing up from the video like it's going to get me. It's almost like 3D. No.
No, don't let it happen.
None for me, thank you. Damn.
Where do we go from here?
Exactly. I think we hit our closer already.
Oh my God.
I know where we go.
Is it time?
Yeah, all I right, think
let's
it
get
is.
You going here from the weekend here.
Oh, I didn't know that's where we're going, but
we're
going.
Where do you want to go?
I don't know. We're going. Do it. Finish it.
All right, let's go.
Finish him.
Let's see how our sports went with this weekend.
Angels beat Minnesota yesterday 2-1. Dodgers lost a heartbreaker. I don't know if it was or not, but they lost 5-3 to Cincinnati.
Didn't break my heart.
On big news, though, big sports news.
Let's have it.
The Rays beat the Braves, right?
Yeah.
At end one intermediate school.
Dumbass.
Everyone ready? Cooper was a beast behind the plate. They pulled off 17-15. We stopped by and watched that game. We told you, free tickets to everyone. ChaoticRadio.com giving you free tickets to go watch the Rays play. If you want to go see them again, they will be playing Wednesday, 5 o'clock,
that
field
is
number one, the Red Sox versus the Rays this week.
That is a nail-biter.
It was actually a great game to watch.
Nice.
We had so much damn fun. It was a good time. So go Rays, go Coop, go the Aldridges, go.
Just go.
Just go. Go see it.
For the love of God, just
go. For the love of cheese, Wednesday, 5 o'clock, they need your support. And
just go.
Man, I even got a foul ball because I'm so damn good with my fingers.
Oh, yeah. Lightning reflex. Well, that puts the Angels are in second place in the West behind Houston, only by a game, so they're having a great season. They're playing 600 ball, 24-16 right now.
Right.
Awesome.
All right.
How my Dodgers do? Oh my God.
Yeah, Dodgers.
Oh,
Dodgers,
yeah. I'm Matt with the Giants last year. We're not last, but we're only 8 games back.
8 games back, only 30 something games in.
Yeah, playing 400 balls, so we're at 16-24. So yeah, we're definitely going to be scraping the bottom this year.
Yeah, but you know,
what do we do to put this team on a winning streak? Is you turn back time and play tomorrow, play last year?
Oh yeah, that wasn't quite a winning streak they ended on though.
Yeah, exactly. Mm. So.
So, Jimmy's like, so.
I don't care.
I'm just moving on.
I don't care. LA determined my ass. It's their hashtag for the year. So sad.
Yankees so sad. Now have 4 10 home run hitters by the 40th game.
Damn.
40 games. And they've got 4 people already at 10 things.
Now, see, that's the division to watch right there. You got 2 rivals. You got the Red Sox Yankees tied for first. Both playing 700 ball.
Right?
Yeah. Yeah, so you would think the Yankees would be a little edged up on there with those Giancarlo and all those home run hitters they paid money for.
Yeah,
Boston's going, nah, we got this. And no big Poppy, right? He retired last year?
Yeah.
Yeah. Boston's like, we got this. No problem.
No problem.
No problem.
And I got my big Poppy shirt.
Yeah?
Because of the play I did.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, because I was a Boston fan.
That's right.
I got the hat, too. Anyone wants a hat, we'll sign it and send it to you. But I wear that shirt because it's actually a comfortable shirt, but I'm afraid to wear it out because everyone will think I'm a Red Sox fan. Well,
I think there was a picture of you wearing it and everyone just jumped on there.
And I'm like, no, it was for a play. But I can't.
It was for theater.
Yeah, theater. I was a thespian. It's a T instead of an L. It's a different thing.
Yeah. You can still be a lesbian, though.
I am.
Matt, go Rays.
I know. That's an awesome game, Matt. It's fun to watch. And saw CFO there.
Yeah.
Or the EGO there, however you want to say it.
We'll go with EGO.
They played earlier in the day.
Yeah.
He said they pulled out a good one. They were down by like six or something runs by the second inning and actually won it in a walk-off in the bottom of the six.
Wow.
Ah, good stuff, right?
That is some good stuff. I'm surprised he stuck around for someone else's game. That's pretty good.
Well, with his EGO.
That's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm done here.
I'm done. I got things to do.
Listen, guys, have a great game. I got to go.
Whatever.
Whatever.
He didn't know we were there, and I snuck up on him as eating a burrito. I leaned all over his shoulder and whispered in his ear, "That looks good." What? What are you doing?
No bites.
Yeah, so that was a lot of fun.
No bites going on right
Wednesday
now.
Night. Don't forget, go catch the Rays beat up on some Sox.
Excellent, and from what I hear, he's becoming quite the catcher.
We got there, he got on.
Yeah.
He got a base hit, and right when he got there, he gunned somebody down trying to steal.
Nice.
And the next inning, gunned somebody down trying to steal again.
See, you know I love catcher stories.
Yes.
I was a catcher.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I love that shit.
That makes sense.
Yeah, it was, Rocket.
Got that rocket arm. Reflexes. Yeah. Boom.
Yeah.
Gotta love it.
Leave it that. So.
Gotta love it.
Yeah. Go Coop.
Go Coop. Got him. Go see the Rays. Go Matt. Fart it up on that 91, buddy. Let people know you're there.
just tell him it's a Jake, man.
There you go. It's a hippo clear out. So. All right. Chaotic Ready time is 7:41. It is Roy and Jimmy in the morning with Donna Main. We're going to be right back. Just call 909-360-8330.
Elvi.
We're just chilling here. Song's about over. I'm like, oh, shit. We're back on here. It's Roy and Jim in the morning. It is chaoticradio.com, home of Ryan Combe, the Ryan Combe fan page. Oop, let me just turn all this off.
You can turn that off now?
The time I gave him shit, and he's actually listening right now. Hi, Ryan. Good morning, buddy.
Good morning.
I did get to the movies this weekend.
What did you see?
We saw, Life of the Party.
With Melissa McCarthy. McCarthy, yeah.
Exactly what you'd expect. Stupid movie. Hilarious. It made me laugh.
Exactly.
We were just talking about
it. Once in a while, you already know it's going to be stupid, and you have to dive right in.
And I don't mean stupid isn't bad. Just like something I don't have to think about. Right. I just, just laugh.
Yeah, you know what's going to be.
Just light entertainment.
Light entertainment, right? Absolutely.
Right?
She made me laugh. Top 10. Number 10. It's going to make us feel bad.
The movies. Top 10.
Top 10.
Well,
for the weekend.
Go.
Number 10 was RBG. No idea.
Oh, that is Ready. No, RGB.
What?
RBG.
Oh, I thought. Okay. RBG.
That's it?
What? I don't know. Let's look that up.
That is domestic totals, as we know. Let's see. Who's in it? I don't know. Weekend charts.
Let's see here. An intimate portrait of an unlikely rock star, Justin.
Yeah, great.
Who? What? With,
I don't know. Oh, it's... It,
sounds
an
like...
An intimate portrait of an unlikely rock star, Justice Ruth Bader Ginsburg, with unprecedented access, the filmmaker explore her early legal battle.
Oh,
that is a ripper right
that's
there.
That's RBG. Talking, huh?
Well, what... Why would you? I don't understand
rock star?
That.
Rockstar? Okay.
Yeah, unlikely rockstar.
Yeah, yeah. Okay. Well,
you know what? I want the trailer for this.
Let's do it.
I want the official trailer for this.
Donna, well, you know.
Well, they called her an unlikely rockstar. I don't understand that at all.
That's probably me. I told Don I was going to go out for The Voice next year.
Are you?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I can't do Idol because I'm too old.
Oh, good God.
All right, never mind. Number nine.
That's all me right there.
Okay, 1.165 million. This is their second week, and they're at 2.02 million. So they picked up some good speed this week, so it looks like.
RGB.
Yeah, because that means they only had 400,000 the first week, and they did 1.1 this week, so that's good.
Okay.
Number nine, Black Panther.
Still
in there.
Number nine. Wow. 13 weeks, 696,186,000. Number eight, Tully, 2018.
Tully.
Yeah, with 2.24 million.
I got nothing.
Second week out, they're at 6.98 million for two
weeks. Tully, is that, I think that's Charlize Theron. Is that the one with her in it?
I'm guessing so. Maybe. I don't know.
Yeah.
God, we don't know nothing. We did this before, too. We didn't know shit.
I haven't seen any movies lately.
All right, I'm going to look up just the basics of this. Tully, 2018 movie. Marlo, it's a girl's name. Marlo is a New York suburbanite who's about to give birth to her third child. Her husband, Ron, is loving and works hard, but remains clueless about the demands that motherhood puts on his wife.
It's a happy-go-lucky Mother's Day movie.
The guy's a dick. She's going to be on her own. Independent woman. Hashtag me too. Hashtag go fuck yourself.
And that's her, right?
Charlize Theron?
Yeah.
Okay.
Number seven, Rampage, 2018.
That's The Rock.
Right. And I'm in 3.38 million.
A little eye candy movie there.
Yes.
Let's see. They've been out 5 weeks for 89,744,000. You know, a good work if you can get it.
He's a primatologist named Davis Okoye.
Of course he is.
Number six.
The Rock with them big arms.
As long as he takes his shirt off.
Who cares?
He doesn't have to take his
shirt off.
He doesn't have to take his shirt off. That's the beauty of him. It's like, what are you hiding under that shirt, bro? No. We know exactly what you got, brother.
And here's the bad thing. I freaking love that guy. He cracks me up. He makes me laugh.
He's enjoyable. Yes.
He is very enjoyable.
Yeah, he's cool. He's a cool guy.
Number six, I Feel Pretty.
That's Amy Schumer.
Yeah, 3.7 million.
I'm not feeling a lot of love from you, Jim.
No, I'm not a big Amy fan.
She comes off as a pig, as Ariana would say. That's how she rates women comics. Man, what a pig.
Did you see that deal where she caught a bunch of shit for going to Caroline's? And a guy was there headlining.
Yes.
And he had a bunch of people there to watch it. And she goes, hey, I want to do it.
And right. She interrupted him.
Now, here's the thing. Yeah. Everyone made a big deal about it. And I sent it to Jimmy. I'm like, that happens all the time.
Yeah. And he went on after her. So,
now, he went on after her, still did it after Amy went. And you know which pub he got for that?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
That's what everybody said. Now you can say, you were the guy you were on the show with Amy Schumer and blah, blah, blah.
Oh, you're that guy? Absolutely. Awesome. I think if it wasn't her, it would be actually, hey, check out what happened to this guy in more of a cheerful tone.
Yeah.
And instead of, you know what that bitch Amy did?
Yeah.
You know, just because the hate on that.
There was a lot of talk because it happens all the time. But I guess she interrupted right in the middle of his set. She went up there, but I mean, she's a celebrity.
Oh, she did that.
It just happened. But she yelled, from off stage, hey, or something. What?
Well, that's actually a dick move right there.
Hey, whatever.
If you bump him before he goes on, that's pretty normal.
You're right. That's kind of what the discussion was.
How's everyone doing? Hey, come on.
Yeah.
All right, I'll check with you later.
They said after that, he had a great set.
He got
on and went on and made fun of it and had a great set.
To work off of,
And it's one of those things we always ask comics, and I don't think we even asked you, is earlier in our careers, if you will, if you want to call this, they would ask, do you want to follow someone who's eating shit, or do you want to follow someone who's killing the crowd? And we would say, oh, eat shit, because I'm going to light this room up.
Yeah.
No, you really don't. It's hard to do that.
Yeah.
And if you got someone in front of you just killing it, it actually ups your game. Inside, you don't even think about it because you're getting all nervous going, man, I hope I can carry this. But you'd rather have someone killing in front of you
keep the room going.
So you follow Amy Schumer?
Whatever.
Yeah, you're going to have a great set.
Have a good time.
Yeah.
Exactly.
And what did I hear? I think I heard that, Steve Martin and Martin Short are performing together.
Yes.
And I think at least one venue, they had Amy open for them.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah,
I heard that's kind of cool, right there.
Yeah,
that's pretty good. I don't know why they have Amy do it, but whatever.
She was on the side of the stage. Hey, big fan. Yeah. You guys are great. All right, shut her up. Bring her out here.
Number five, A Quiet Place. Sixth week, 6.4 million total.
Scary one, huh?
Total in six weeks is 169 million.
They're pulling it.
Yeah.
Number four. I'm kind of intrigued about maybe watching it.
What do you got?
Number four is Overboard.
No, I don't want to watch
it. And the only reason is because I loved the original.
Yeah, well, that was classic.
But they switched it. The girl is now the... They switch roles.
Right.
So
right.
I wonder how that's going to go.
Yeah.
10.1 million, 2 weeks at 29.5 million. Mm. Good run.
Not really, because their budget was 12 mil.
Right.
Yeah, so they're not making that.
Well, they're almost there.
That's... you're the one who did the... You put this phrase in my head years and years ago.
Okay.
They did a remake of Funky Town.
Okay.
The song Funky Town.
Right.
There was a remake of it. And Roy looked at me and said, "Is nothing sacred?"
True though,
and it made me laugh. But I use that every time when this kind of reboots happen. So they're redoing Overboard with Anna Faris. Is nothing sacred? Why you got to touch it?
And that was the first one was so good. I really thought it was good.
Yeah. With Kurt Russell, the kids, and every time they do something, they said, "What are they doing?" They're making out a Christmas list when they find out she's rich.
Right.
I use that line all the time. Yeah. We're making Christmas lists out now.
Right.
Coming to an influx of money or something like that. Ooh, a bonus. Oh, make me a new Christmas list. That's what's going on right there. And then his buddy in the original, when he found the underwear in the glove box.
Yeah, he's taking the fall. Yeah,
I was unfaithful. That was me.
Taking the fall movie. For him.
Yeah.
Number three, Breaking In, 2018.
Breaking In. I don't know this movie. Let's
first week, 16.5 million.
Breaking In movie. Let's see what's going on with this thing here.
I've heard a little bit about it.
Gabrielle Union, Billy Burke. Let's see here. Sean Russell takes her son and daughter on a weekend getaway to her late father's secluded high-tech vacation home in the countryside. The family soon gets an unwelcome surprise when four men break into
suspense.
The house.
Yes. Well, is it? Yeah.
So that's a good nail-biter kind of movie, I would think.
Uh-huh. Number two, we were part of that. Life of the Party.
Life of the Party, Melissa McCarthy.
First week out, 18.5 million.
Oh, they're good. They'll make it. They got a 30 mil budget. Released just, Friday?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, Maya Rudolph's in it, so I got to say it. I love her.
Oh, you know what?
Oh, she's amazing.
She was funny in it, too.
Always funny.
The part she played was, you're not giving anything away, she played Melissa's friend.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And she was, I'll say is she was... Maybe living a little bit vicariously through her because Melissa went back to school and you kind of know what was going on there,
right?
You know, and she just kind of like woo. She was like, "Yes, I got to go back to school." It was a good time
when her husband suddenly dumps her. Longtime dedicated housewife Deanna turns regret into reset by going back to college.
Yes,
these are great lines for the for these movies. These taglines.
Well, just two funny ladies in it. So I would like
hands down Maya Rudolph. I'm in for that
she's
one.
She's fantastic.
There's a little plot twist one time that Maya just killed the scene. I mean, something happened there that just, oh my God, I was rolling.
One of my favorite things she did on SNL is when her and Fred Armisen, he would do Prince and she was Beyonce. And then the Prince show. That just made me Beyonce. Laugh every time.
That was so good.
And number one.
Dun, dun, dun. Say it.
I can't wait.
Avengers. Infinity Wars.
Such a good movie.
61 million for the weekend. Now look, number two was 18. Avengers is 61.8 million. 3 weeks.
Wow.
3 weeks at $547 million.
Holy moly. You know that there's a lot of nerds.
Yeah,
in
and
this
that is more than Black Panther on their opening first few weeks. And Black Panther is still in theaters.
Right.
Yeah.
And now Black Panther is actually available to buy digitally, and it's still in theaters.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. I saw it on Amazon Prime. Yeah. It was ready to buy. You're like, are you kidding me? So you can have it in any form, and people are still going to pay money to go see this
Isn't
thing.
Isn't that something?
Well, I'll tell you what, man. I dropped that whole nerd thing way too soon.
Yeah.
I was like two sweater vests away from being Sheldon the rest of my life. That's how the I was rest being brought up.
See?
Roy was with me in school. I had the sweater vest. I had a collared shirt. Horn rim glasses. Yeah.
You pulled it off, though.
Because you can't really, there's not a lot of steps in being a nerd. You either got it nailed or you're almost all the way there.
Yeah. One of my favorite nerds in movies.
What?
All time, and not Revenge of the Nerds, guys, none of those, was Robin Williams.
Yeah.
And what was the name of that movie?
What movie?
And when he was with Kurt Russell in a football movie.
Oh, Best of Times.
Best of Times.
That's a great movie.
God, he played the biggest dork. Was perfect.
That is a great movie. I love that movie.
See, now somebody's going to remake that.
No. Don't do that.
What about when Sandler redid The Longest Yard?
That's not too bad.
Longest Yard, the original was, I mean, the second one wasn't bad.
Yeah, actually, the second one wasn't bad. That's old enough, I guess. Because
it was like mid-70s, had to be.
Yeah, Burt Reynolds and all that with The Longest Yard. Yeah. Yeah.
Mm. They had real football players knocking the shit out of people.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. Pacino, too, right?
No.
No, that's the other football movie.
No.
That was nothing.
Yeah, that was
nothing I even thinking about.
No.
Was that one of Keanu Reeves?
Was it Hackman in that one, too?
Yeah, there was like a lot of football movies at that time.
Hackman was in that, too, wasn't
Gene
he? Yeah, Gene
Hackman
the coach?
and Keanu Reeves, yeah.
One of my favorite ones was the one with...
I'm a football player!
Right, was the one with Sinbad.
With Sinbad?
Yeah, with Sinbad and Kathy Ireland was the kicker.
Oh, shit, I'm going to look that up.
You never saw that?
I don't think so. It's not.
Oh, my God, it was... and who played the... wasn't Hackman, it was... I can't remember the guy's name. He played one of the coaches. Was great. Alfonso. No. Oh my God, the guy's name left me. I know his name.
Necessary Roughness.
Yes.
Scott Bakula.
Right. He was quarterback.
Yeah.
But what was the coach's name? He's a famous guy.
Let's get to it.
Look to the.
Yeah, here Scott Bakula, Hector Elizondo.
Hector Elizondo.
Robert Loggia.
Yeah.
Oh, this is a great cast. Larry Miller, Sinbad, Jason Bateman. I'll watch anything with Jason Bateman.
I am waiting for. Oh my gosh, it's not. I almost said Fargo. Ozark to come back.
One of my doppelganger things. I have the Jeff Goldblum thing. Kenny Loggins, Scott Bakula turned up. I can see a little bit.
But you never saw Necessary Roughness?
I don't. No, it came out like what, early 90s. So no, I did not.
Oh, I think it was 80s maybe. What does it say?
Yeah, 91.
91. Okay.
Yeah.
Funny movie. Kathy Ireland was a kicker. They suck so bad they need a kicker, and all of a sudden they saw a soccer player kick the shit out of something. They went, huh? And it was her.
And that brought in. That brought in the fans and I can see it. It's a feel good, sure.
And Sinbad was actually a teacher, but he didn't like. He had 1 year of eligibility left for some weird reason,
right?
So he ended up coming to play, and he does the dance.
I love Sinbad, especially his early stand up. Big fan of all that, and I kick myself every time. About 4 or 5 years ago, we went up to Seattle, flew to Seattle out of LAX, and there was Sinbad. He had his big old long trench on, his guitar. He was flying to Seattle to do a show, and I was being one of those guys going, I don't want to bug him. And I should have.
Yeah.
Such a huge fan. I'll never see him again.
So funny.
And he's just being nice to everybody. People are coming up to him. Yeah. I go, I don't want to be that dick. I'm like, shit, be the dick.
Yeah.
Be the dick. I love
him. It's your chance.
Yeah. I love him.
I think I saw that he has been around the area recently, or he will be soon. I saw something about him recently.
Yeah, he's hitting a lot of shows again. He's doing I love that all these comics that we saw when we were younger who got us interested in this are back on tour and hitting these little places so we can go see him again. It's just, it was like Rich Heidner and getting to know him. And then I went to one of his little coffee house little recitals where he's doing this, more stories from the book he promoted on our show. It's just great to interact with these people from back in the day. Infinity Wars, they're killing it.
Yeah, they're killing
the shit. I haven't seen any of these movies.
I didn't hear about a lot of them. I really need to keep up, especially if we're doing this morning show shit.
Yeah.
Especially when Rogue runs the box. 2 weeks ago, shame on us, we got to get caught up. Today, we're like, oh shit, we didn't look.
Research.
I have no.
Research.
I have no idea. It's like, we'll never do like the top five songs that are popular right now on iTunes like Blaine used to do, because I have no idea what they are. No idea.
I'm trying to look for something that's going to make me laugh here.
Good morning.
Well,
Tony Storm says good morning.
Oh, good morning, Tony Storm. How are you?
There it is. There it is. That's what I was looking for.
What's that? What do you got?
Is this going to beat the hippopotamus?
You really got you set the bar kind of high for yourself right now, Roy, for hippopotamus butt explosion.
Yeah. I don't know. It's a tough one to follow.
I'm ready for this right here.
All right, what do you got? Take us out. Yeah, this is
gonna be, no, it'll just be a second here.
Yeah.
Today. Oh, well, what happened? Oh, there it is. I got to turn the volume on. There's always that, you know,
sure.
Volume. All right. And Jimmy was there.
I guess around that. And if he had come to me from the beginning, years ago, to say what the most important thing was about this surgery, all those things he said are true, but he left out one important part that makes your fucking dick look way bigger.
That's you.
That's me. Today, the 14th of May, 2018.
Yeah.
Stand-Aid debut was in 2009 today. First time I ever went on stage, and that was the set.
The lucky strike, yeah. Wow.
That was the set, and boy, what a mess it was.
Well, you got busy. It's kind of cool. Kind of cool. You know, when you got a little nut to work with, and now you got something, you know, well, maybe not swinging, but something substantial.
What are you doing, dude?
I always think we all should go back to, like, our first open mic set and do them now.
Yeah.
Donna, really?
Donna's like, good luck with that, guys.
I don't know about that.
Let's see, where am I?
I have to, I don't even remember.
Where am I going now?
Sorry, man. Everyone always says you want to look around and look at people in their underwear, right? Relax when you're up front. Hell with it. Underwear? Don't work. Boxers, briefs, bras.
Are you pointing to
just
people?
Just fall away. Just see them naked. One naked. The second one, if you want to not ever be intimidated, think of all the people looking at you when they're sitting on the shitter.
Genius.
Wow.
I don't even know if I got my first stuff with me. It is Roy Jimmy in the morning. It is 808 chaoticradio.com. We're coming back at you with more traffic, weather, sports, and whatever you want to talk about. 909-360-8330. We're coming back.
See you in a minute. Welcome back to Roy and Jimmy in the Morning here on chaoticradio.com.
We are hooping it up.
Hoop.
We are
hooping and hollering.
Hooping and hollering. Chaotic Radio time is 8:19.
Oh, already?
Wow. Already, we're flying through. We always do. Yeah. We always do.
Flying.
We saw Tony Lightning jumped in.
Yes, he did.
Was that his 90-day lightning?
Yes.
Okay, just check.
Lightning, storm,
the quiet thunder.
Pitter patter.
We were talking about this off camera. Roy said that Kylie is getting a new job, and part of new job training is sexual harassment.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Mm-hmm. Yes. I want to have a questionnaire on sexual harassment.
A questionnaire? You pull one up?
I want to find one. You got one?
No, I don't have one. I didn't know where you were going, but yeah.
I want to see what they ask.
As a manager in the positions I have been in before, I've got to go to... It's like an hour just on that alone.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And, you know, on all the different types. Yeah. And then you got to answer.
Yes.
What type is, you know,
is this considered
harassment or what type of harassment is it considered?
Right, yes.
You know, is it quid pro quo? Is it whatever, you know, this for that?
And yeah.
It's like, wow. In depth.
Yeah. It's pretty intricate these days, yes.
Jimmy's still looking.
I'm still looking.
You looking? Okay.
Cornhole update.
Speaking of.
Oh, yes. We were talking about the people that are passionate about their cornhole.
Yes.
They are.
Cody Henderson right now is our number one ranked player for the week. He's from Ohio. Jordan Camba is number two. Adam Hisner, three. James Baldwin, got a Baldwin. Virginia. And, hotspot, Alan Rockwell from Virginia is top five. So those are the top five. And Tony, again, there are no California people in the top 15.
Oh, well, boy.
And with the weather we have, you would think.
Well, this guy's name, Chucky Love. How about Michael Dingus? Brandon Corwin is the cornhole number nine.
We're in the area.
And Wallace Justice. Wallace Justice.
All right.
So just so you know, that's where...
Nobody from California, huh?
Well, if I'm looking at the advance, the next one's in Columbia.
Columbia?
Columbia.
Yeah. Well, Columbia, Pennsylvania.
I was going to say, damn.
Columbia where, yeah.
And the New York Cornhole May Doubles Regional is in Riverhead, New York.
Doubles Regional.
Cumberland Plateau Regional, number six, is in Crossville, Tennessee. And the May Singles Regional is in, Mesa, Arizona. Here we go.
There we go. We're getting close.
Getting closer.
Okay.
So, Tony,
I think you guys need to start playing in California.
We got to represent.
I think the cornhole is beckoning you.
The cornhole is calling you.
The cornhole is calling my name. Yeah. So was it on the hippo that Jimmy played earlier.
Right. Blow it out your ass.
California North versus California South at Chewy's Mesquite Broiler in Bakersfield is May 26th.
Bakersfield, that sounds about right.
Yeah. Nothing to do but cornhole there.
And California North versus South on the 27th. Those are the only ones I see in California. Not much going on in California in cornholing. Everyone's a little too uptight for the cornhole.
A little too tight.
I think maybe you can change that, Roy.
You got to loosen them up.
Tony, cornhole it up here.
Yeah.
Did you see the thing with the Arizona woman? Went out on a date with a guy and then got in trouble. They went on one date and then she broke into his house.
Yes.
And they found a knife in the car.
The stalker. Yeah, yeah.
She sent 65,000 texts to him.
Yes.
Damn. Jesus.
Do you know her? You know her, Jimmy?
Oh, my God. It's just
65,000.
Holy shit.
She's got a little crazed look there. Did you see that?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Her name was Jacqueline, was found parked outside of the victim's Paradise Valley home, police said. The man also accused her of repeatedly texting him, despite saying he no longer wanted to be involved with her. One date. Now, she sent 65,000 texts to the man's phone. The victim said that she sent about 500 to him a day.
500 per day. I was going to ask.
500 texts a day.
I was going to ask. Wow.
Quote is, I felt like I met my soulmate.
Oh, right.
Oh, wow.
In one of her messages, she allegedly stated, "Don't ever try to leave me. I'll kill you. I don't want to be a murderer."
But she said that in a loving way.
Yeah, don't make me kill you.
That's the problem.
Honey.
With text messages, you can't tell tone. You can't tell the tone.
You lose the affliction. Yes.
Maybe she put a happy face at the end of it.
I'm it was enough.
I like to see the emojis on this thing here.
Yeah.
You got the eggplant, you got the little peach cheek, and then you got a knife and a gun.
A dagger.
Yeah,
a
knife, gun, kissy faces, wink, wink, wink.
Yes.
I'm looking at her picture here. You know, maybe you could have zhuzhed it up a little bit. A little makeup, a little hair. A little something. Give him a little fear of loss. I mean, you are crazy, but look at the rack on this one. I mean, give him something.
Yeah.
Yeah. Because she looks not enticing in this the jumpsuit orange right now.
He just needed a little motivation there. A little.
Wow. She was found in the bathtub of the man's home and had a large knife in her car. Jesus, that's where they found
her.
Now,
was
in the
bathtub. Taking a bath? Was she naked?
She thought a tornado was coming because you're supposed to hop in the bathtub in a tornado.
We need some more details.
Oh, my God.
We need some more details.
Told reporters she was in love.
Well, one date, you know.
Well, they locked her up and put her in jail. And then once they locked her up and put her in jail, she said that, okay, I'll leave him alone now. Oh, I believe you.
Yeah.
I'm sure you're done.
After 65,000 texts, you guys convinced me in 5 minutes.
Her thumbs must... She must have arthritis. My God.
Got no thumbprints? That's...
I don't think I've sent 65,000 texts in my life.
Right, ever.
Right.
And Matt says, how are we not sponsoring the Bakersfield cornhole?
She has mad skills, that woman. I'll tell you.
I'll tell you. She's texting. Everything is autocorrect. She didn't have to type anything. One word.
Yeah. She was definitely a swipe to text her.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Matt Starr, that's how are we not sponsors of the Bakersfield Cornhole Tournament? We must get a banner up there.
Right.
You are correct, yeah. Sir.
Get a banner. We got a banner.
We got a banner. Cornhole.
That's perfect.
Your home, your cornhole home.
This will be the cornhole capital of Southern California.
Need to relax on the cornhole, yeah, Tony said.
Oh, okay.
I don't know if we need to relax on it or that was being funny. I don't know which one it was. I don't know how to read Tony at that one. Again, the affliction of the response is in text.
Right. You can't tell.
The California uptight comment. Oh, I get it. There it is. See, but that maybe she was taken wrong. Maybe this Arizona woman was just, she wasn't completely understood proper. Let's see if we can.
He was my soulmate.
Let's see.
In the bathtub.
See what they say. Click the watch. Okay, I'll do it. Didn't work. Great news story.
Mm. We have a related site popped up. It says textual healing, how to stop a text stalker.
Textual healing.
Yes, it's number one, ask them to stop.
Well, apparently he did that.
Yeah, sounds simple. Say, yeah, I think sounds he probably simple, but did that after about the 10,000th text.
Ask them to stop. Yeah. Sounds simple, but it's your first step to ending an abusive relationship. Mm-hmm. Number two, block them where you can. Number three, stop responding. Well, I think those are all the go-tos. Mm-hmm. Don't ever initiate contact. Yeah, don't go back in 3 days going, was he you up? Yeah. Who is? Block text, report to the police, and there we go.
Yeah.
And then change your number.
Well, wow, this just popped up and caught my eye on the top.
I'd like to know what some more of those text messages said.
Right.
You know? Yeah.
Because, here we go. Now it's finally playing. Maybe.
Okay.
Maybe. The screen went black. On the top of their web... Oh, that's it did. It's playing a commercial. Good. See? I'm smarter than you now.
Yes, what do you got?
No, it's coming up. I'm waiting for the commercial.
Oh, gotcha.
Oh, we have to watch the ad first.
We have to get out of the commercial first.
Sure, can't do anything now.
Yeah.
I can do anything now. On the top of this website, though, it says, Supreme Court clears way for legalized sports betting nationwide. What?
Huh.
Someone paid off. That's a lobbying thing right there.
What?
I know they were all over DraftKings and all that, saying no, we don't do that. Well, we're hit to that because of the
this
online.
This woman
poker.
Did not just walk into a home that she wasn't invited to, but then she made herself right at home.
When police arrived to the Paradise Valley home last month, they found 31-year-old Jacqueline Aides in the man's bathtub. The victim says he met her online and the pair went on one date over a year ago, but she won't leave him alone.
He got arrested on allegations of stalking, a class 5 felony.
According to court documents, that appears to be true. Aides trespassed onto his property last July and allegedly again in December. She's also accused of sending him more than 65,000 text messages. That's 500 a day. Some very threatening and disturbing. Things like, don't ever try to leave me. I'll kill you. I want to wear your body parts and bathe in your blood. Officers found a butcher knife in her car when she was most recently arrested. She's now in jail with no bond.
We did talk with an expert about situations like this. She suggests avoiding contact at all costs, upping your security measures, maybe getting some video alarms and extra locks on your doors. And of course, saving everything so it can be handed over to police and help with an investigation. Reporting in Phoenix tonight, Lexi Suter, ABC 15, Arizona.
How did he let this go on, or how is he able to deal with this for over a year?
I have no idea.
Well, the thing is, you probably don't know how to deal with something like that.
Yeah.
I mean, that is overwhelming.
You know, you want the evidence, but over a year?
Yeah. Oh, my God.
Wow. 500 texts a day. I mean, your phone would blow up.
Yeah.
Well, you know, a lot of them are like, you know, hi.
Maybe not.
How are you?
Like, you there?
Oh my God!
Yeah.
You there?
Yeah.
Maybe didn't get my last text.
Maybe like three or four one worders, and then the whole.
And then I want to bathe in your blood.
Then I want to bathe in your blood. I want to bathe in your blood. Call me.
Yeah.
You there?
Well,
you
we back? All do crazy working? Things when we're in love, right?
We can put it down there. All he had to do was go. just had some diarrhea in front of her. That might have killed it.
Maybe she was into it.
Yeah. He said, listen, man, I gotta go.
I got to go.
What a crazy world. Oh, boy.
She wanted to play cornhole with him. That was probably as innocent as that.
Yeah.
He said, do you like cornhole? She went, oh, my God.
Well,
oh, my God, this is the guy.
Okay, there was one date, but we don't know what happened. That's on right. That date.
That's interesting.
They left always, that out.
There's
they
always the fine out. Print. Yeah. Yes.
So you're playing devil's advocate saying, wait, we don't know both sides.
Yeah.
What about this guy?
This guy, maybe he just wanted to get laid, told her what she wanted to hear.
Yeah.
Didn't get laid that night, went, ah, okay, maybe someone else. And she's like, oh my God, he farted in front of me, he loves me. And you don't know what her trigger was. You don't know what her trigger was.
Yeah.
Yeah. He was probably just trying to get laid.
Yeah.
And now he's paying the price.
So we don't,
that's a little over the top, though.
Well, but you said you don't know. You don't know what happened on the date.
Was that like a 24-hour date? We don't know.
Exactly. Yeah, and what'd they do on the date?
But even if he let her on, a year later when he's not wanting to talk to her.
But this is going on over a year.
You know, if we look into her dating history or all that, maybe no one wanted to. You never know. You never know what he did to trigger what she did.
Right, right. We're missing, like we said,
there's always a trigger.
We're missing a few bits of information. There's always a trigger.
I mean, I am not feeling bad for the guy. I do feel bad for the guy because this is over the top. But there's one thing that happened on that date that made the shit go down.
Something.
Yeah, something went down.
Yeah.
Something went down.
Yeah, it could have been.
You never know. You owe me, and I'll get back to you on that.
All right.
You never know.
Yeah. But after a year, Jimmy.
I understand.
Oh, yeah.
I understand, but there's always a trigger.
But, you know, maybe he got her a Bloody Mary with bacon in it. I don't know. It was
the mimosa, you know,
something.
The mimosas were flowing. Yeah. You never know. You never know what triggers these people. Something I wouldn't do, but...
Right.
And I wouldn't know what to do if that shit happened to me.
I don't know.
I'd be sharing everything with Roy. There's my proof of service right there.
It was the date that rocked her world. That's all I know.
Yes. Yeah. Felt like it was a soulmate.
Well, here's the thing now. Do all other women go, well, hey, what's this guy got going on?
Yeah. Exactly. Yeah, it kind of made him popular. Well,
if he probably doesn't need... Probably doesn't need, you know, Tinder now.
Yeah, he turned, you know, if he can turn her crazy, you know, some women are going, you know, this guy sounds pretty good.
She probably was already crazy. I'm just guessing. Just, you know.
Could be.
It's a stretch, I know. But I would like to know the rest of the story.
Right.
What happened on that date?
One thing turned her.
Yeah.
Right. I don't want to know the rest of the story. She's
I do. I want to go. I'm on 60 minutes on this shit. I want to know what's going on.
Now that we've gotten this far.
Yeah, now I'm curious.
We know that it went on for over a year.
Yeah.
Yeah. I want to know more.
Maybe of sending her text to kind of bite her. You know, one day, maybe. I've been busy at work. Yeah. You know, maybe because he wasn't forthright about, you know, ending it.
Yeah, maybe.
Something was keeping her going. Well, some little thing was keeping her going.
Yeah.
All right. I'm done. Kept going.
Enough stalker talk for you?
Yeah.
Okay. This is Stalker Talk on Roy and Jimmy in the Morning, CatholicRadio.com. It is 8:34. You're almost late to work.
Give us a call, 867-530. Oh, wait. Wrong one. 909-360. Let's see. You give me something. Welcome back to Roy and Jimmy in the Morning. That's what that girl was saying. He was my kind of lover.
Oh, yeah. Soulmate kind of lover. Yeah. All the lovers.
Right.
Yes.
All the lovers. Tana brought up a good point. The first song we played was Jenny. And she said, you can forget. You always forget your passwords.
Right.
You can always remember Jenny's phone number.
Right. Yes, yes.
No matter what.
30-year song. This song's right. Old, like 30 years old. Jenny. You got Jenny's number? Yeah, I got it. Jenny. I got it.
I got your number on the wall.
Just get off my back.
Right. Yeah, I don't think you want to take Jenny home to mother. I don't think that's the girl, but...
I don't think she's the girl for you.
No.
You should make a song with just her name in it. the stalker girl, Jackie.
Jackie.
You're not the girl for me.
You're not the girl for me. Yeah.
Let it go.
You text too long. You make me all freaky.
I got your number in the tub.
My thumb's like fire. No, texting like fire. What do you never go next?
Next, we better get our. We're winding down here already.
Oh, boy.
Roy and Jimmy in the Morning, Chaotic Radio. Time is 8:44. We get a little weather update. Oh, see yes. How we're doing across the U.S. of the A's.
Alrighty. Well, here in the lovely town of Rancho Cucamonga, currently no volcanic activity, but it is 58 degrees and sunny, and the high today will be 74 degrees. That's very pleasant.
That's comfy.
Pleasant, right? And once again, Cut and Shoot, Texas, it is now 82 degrees, partly cloudy. High is going to be 91. We're sticking with that.
Yeah, they're going to be warm.
Yes. Let's go over Jimmy's hometown, Waterbury, Connecticut.
Yes.
It is now 58 degrees, cloudy. A high of 73, though, today. So it is going to warm up a bit. Yes.
Nice.
Not bad. And we're going to travel up to San Francisco. It is cloudy at this time, 53 degrees. As we know, it can be a little cloudy in the Bay Area.
Yes.
The high today will only be 59 degrees.
A little
chilly there today. Gotta wear a coat, jacket.
Gotta wear a coat, jacket,
yeah,
something.
Yeah, something like that.
Warm up a little bit.
Yeah. Yep. Very good, very good.
Okay.
And what our last minute, we'll fire up the chaoticradio.com Kudos Pizzeria.
Yes.
Traffic helicopter.
I'm hungry.
Oh, yeah. Start off with breakfast, pizza.
210 freeway westbound at Archibald. Crash has been moved to the right shoulder. Speeds are down to 16 miles an hour. 91 freeway westbound, starting to slow right around Maple Street, down again to 18 miles an hour. Just reported 57 southbound accident on the shoulder at Via Verde. Ooh. Speeds are starting to slow there. And
that's not good.
Via Verde's got a soft spot for you guys.
It's too close to home.
You both went, ooh.
And 57 southbound in Brea, right around Lambert. Speeds dropping to 22 miles an hour. We do have a new one. There's a new one. Crash along the right side. 215 southbound at Mills. Speeds are down to 16 at 3rd Street.
Eek. Yikes.
And that's your latest traffic update.
Oh, and our quick little weather report. 63 degrees in Shank and Stab, Orange County from Tony Storm.
Oh.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Tony Storm with the update right there.
Cool.
Thanks, Tony.
Still a little cool. Yeah.
Well, there you go. There's your traffic. Mm-hmm. There's your weather. We are wrapped.
And it's clear and sunny and Stray Bullet OC.
It's a good day to be in those towns.
All right.
Our shaker update, over the weekend.
Hawaii's been is affecting the old the earth right now.
Something's going on.
So.
At yesterday at 10:52, Cantuga Creek was a 2.4. Thousand Palms had a 2.2. Now here we go. Ocotillo Wells.
Mm-hmm.
Ready? A 2.3, a 2.4, a 2.2, a 2.3, and a 2.8 all yesterday.
Lots of rumbling.
That's a lot of moving.
Yeah.
Lake Henshaw had a 2.4 yesterday, about 10:44. Mammoth Lakes is always shaking. It's a damn volcano anyway. It had a 2.2. But that's your latest 48-hour update.
And would you say you had a friend of yours call you up, let you know?
Yeah. A buddy of mine, Greg, Greg Fox, who's really into it, he sent me a thing, recent earthquakes in California and Nevada, and sent a map, and he's into it, and I'll show you guys the map. Mm. Here's the map for our area, for the recent earthquakes. So, you can see, it's been pretty busy.
Yeah.
A lot of squares. And it's not just what we read, but, I mean, some are smaller. And all he said is, are you ready with water and food? Be ready.
Yeah.
We
need to prepare.
Get those kits we've all supposed to be having since we're in grade school.
Uh-huh.
Right.
Now, over on Central, just below Foothill, there is that supply store.
That's survival.
survival store.
Survival place, yeah.
Oh, that's right. That's been there forever.
They got all the mannequins out.
I love that. I love their demo out there. They change it up every week or so.
No, maybe
it's
put a couple
it's
things.
It's fun. It's fun.
couple things under the counter. Get those by the door, just in case.
Yeah.
Right? And every time you're like, you know what? You don't, but yeah.
I'm going to throw my back out. I've got a 5-gallon thing of sparklets by the door. I'll be taking that with me.
Yeah.
Yeah. You get everything else. I got the water. Handful of the chips and water. We'll be all set.
Handful of what?
Chips.
Chips.
Yeah. Chips and candy and then water. We'll be all set.
There you go. Because you can live a long time on chips and candy.
Yes, you can. As long as you got that water to wash it down, you'll be all set.
Well, we learned on the show you can only go like 13 days without eating.
That's right. 13 days.
I would imagine.
Without sustenance of some kind.
Right.
You had all the apples. You're eating for a long time.
Long time.
An apple a day of all varieties.
We woke up yesterday and it was quiet outside early.
Was it
really
a little too quiet?
Yeah, and it was kind of rainy a little bit.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
And there was no noise from the dogs. We couldn't hear the freeway. Nothing was going on. And I told she asked me, she said, sometimes your brain scares me. And I'm like, what if something bad happened? And we're the only ones left.
Ooh.
That slow peek out the window?
Right. And I said,
it was very quiet in the morning.
Yeah, and I'm like, I don't hear anything. Yeah. Nothing. Not a car driving by. And it went a long time. Yeah. And finally, I'm like, I'm going to have to go look.
Yeah.
And I actually peeked out the window to see if things were going on.
Did you slowly peek out?
I did a slow peek. But then I came up with, hey, if something bad like that happened.
Step by step.
Slowly first step. Are we the only ones? Step two.
I said, we can go to Vaughn's right there around the corner. And she looked at me because I know where Vaughn's is at. Oh, yeah, I forgot. But I said, instead of bringing all the food here, I think we move our furniture into Vaughn's.
Well, the way these supermarkets are, Albertsons, Vaughn's, there's already furniture there. Up on the top shelves.
Right.
They got the wicker chairs and all that.
Yeah, they get. Right now they have all the summer patio.
You already got
a
place to stake
your
claim on top of one of the aisles.
Yeah.
So, I mean, I don't want to go get the food. I just live in the food. We can live a long time at Vaughn's.
Yeah.
I'll lock up the doors, let anyone in, unless they know a secret password.
Right?
Right, because there's probably like zombies.
All I can do is put a rake or a shovel across the doors and you own this place.
Tony's coming up with The Walking Dead. And it cracked me up because I really don't like that show. I can't even watch it.
Right.
But I started going there. I'm like, well, maybe the zombies come. And it's like, why did I go to zombies? I hate the show. But why did I go to zombies?
Why did I go there?
Right. But I could be in the, but there's a problem. And this makes me wonder about houses, too. Everyone's like, double lock, triple lock, put all these deadbolts on the door. Mm. Every house has a window. Okay. Yeah. How many locks you put on it? Done.
Right. Yeah. Right.
I'm in.
One good kick, you're in.
Oh, yeah.
Right. So, is it a false sense of security having a lock on your door?
If someone wants to really get in...
Yeah, if it's a zombie apocalypse, definitely.
Sometimes the quick lock jiggle is like, it's not worth the effort, I'm out to hit the next one. Because there's more houses than yours.
Right.
Yeah. And you got to, unless you have something really, really.
Yeah.
Yeah, because now if I'm at Vaughn's, I got to do something about them windows.
It's loaded with windows, yes.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, the front doors are all windows. Now, someone's going to come through a window.
All glass.
What am I going to put up there? Stop the zombies.
Exactly. I don't even know what the secret thing to zombies is.
I don't know what I can put up.
I don't know what their kryptonite would be.
Because they walk right through the glass.
Well,
I
know they use crossbows. You just got to have crossbows.
I don't think Vaughn's got crossbows yet. So we got
to
actually hold up.
I happen to like The Walking Dead.
We got
to
hole up into the surplus store because hopefully they got some ammo and shit going on there. Crossbows. Archery. Archery will take down the Living Dead.
Okay, so I'm wondering now, do I decide to go out of there?
Because you don't want them to get your brain, you know. You don't want them to get your brain. Yeah.
Maybe I just make a quick stop at Vaughn's and load up my truck. And then I decide to go over and live in Bass Pro Shops.
True. Matt's telling us to relax. He goes, if the four of us, him, me, Rory, and Ryan... Walk in the same area, it's already a 2.3 earthquake. We're some big fellas.
Well, it's true. That's a little truth to it. But whoa.
Ooh.
Hey, Roy.
Was that me?
Yeah.
Oh.
Ding. Hi, buddy.
I'm waiting for an announcement.
Exactly.
Matt, relax, you weirdos.
That's what I'm just saying, yeah.
What?
We already carry enough girth to rattle the floor a little bit.
Relax, you weirdos. That wasn't good. Hmm. Why do you gotta be so angry?
He's a listener. He can say anything he wants.
Oh, that's right. Well, he's commander.
He's commander, man.
He's a commander. He can do that. And a coach of a winning, the winning Rays team.
Oh. For the weekend, absolutely.
For the weekend. Right. They're going to win again Wednesday. I feel it in my bones. They're going to beat the Sox. Wednesday, 5:00. Etiwanda Intermediate School. Free tickets to Roy and Jimmy Show listeners. Go check it out.
That's cool. Oh, that sounds like
you fun. Know what was bad is they we're on the keto thing, right? We walk up. Yeah. They don't just have they have a snack bar as you're walking by. Mm. They have a trailer set up for churros.
Oh.
And you can get a churro for $3.25, or you can get the churro that's in an ice cream.
Oh boy.
For $7. Oh my God! I wanted a churro
that's
so bad.
Tough.
Jimmy's our skinny friend.
No,
Ryan?
No bacon.
They could. They had enough toppings. They might have had maple and bacon.
Yeah,
the maple kind.
Yeah. Oh yeah. The maple kind.
The maple kind. Yeah. So Ryan says Jimmy's our skinny friend. I'm packing about 240 pounds. So yeah, I'll make an impression. Yeah. I'll make an impression, buddy.
Yeah, Jimmy's got a heavy foot. Throwing some 240 pounds around. We're only allowed one skinny friend. Well, you know why? Because there was another fat ass like me. It was Roy and Jimmy. Like we'd be doing 3.2s, not 2. Whatever's. Can I call in and play a trivia game to win tickets? Absolutely, you can call in to win trivia.
No, you've got 3 minutes. You can't.
Oh yeah, I can make it.
You're gonna have to book the show tomorrow, dude.
Yeah, you're gonna have to call tomorrow.
Yeah, tomorrow.
Get off your high horse.
We know you're a big in charge kind of guy.
Yeah, big in charge, doing all that stuff. We don't have time for you now.
No one has time.
Hey, unless there's some angel tickets involved, then I'm in.
You're going to be so in, yes.
Make an exception.
Yeah, exception. And we're on a tight time thing here. We're not one of those shows that runs over and does that kind of stuff.
No, we show respect, man.
Mm-hmm. For the rest of the shows on our network.
Exactly. In fact, tonight...
Attaboy.
Tonight on chaoticradio.com at 5 to 7 tonight is another replay of the Roy and Jimmy thing / morning show. I believe we'll do the rerun of this one tonight at 5.
All
and
right.
Tomorrow we're back here 7 to 9 for the morning show and our show 8 to 10 Tuesdays.
Yeah.
Yes.
Cool.
We haven't been live on Tuesdays for a couple weeks. I don't know if we'll do it again. This week. Who knows?
It remains a mystery.
Until tomorrow.
Until tomorrow when we decide how tired we are.
Tune in tomorrow.
But tonight, live, 7 to 9, our buddy Zig in the Zig Zone, right here at chaoticradio.com.
All the way from...
Sam Bernardino. Roy told me he was named after a guy named Sam.
Yes. Well, Zig thinks it was.
Yes. Beautiful Sam Bernardino. Right now he's cussing.
I know that was the best. Did you see the response?
No, I haven't seen. I just see these quick little.
Oh yeah, you need to see that one's the best.
Dumbass, be yelling at us.
They're yelling.
Don't yell at us.
Well, actually, another conversation went in there. It kind of made me laugh a little bit. So, wow, it took me all. It just took me right off the thing when I saw it.
Yeah,
I just know the answer. All I can say the answer. No, I can't even say the answer Ryan put in there. That would not be good either. I thought maybe if I didn't put it in together, people wouldn't put it together, but maybe.
Yeah, we got some smart listeners.
All right, never mind. We're about done.
Yeah, I think we're done.
We're bantered out. Send texts people don't want them.
Exactly. Don't be a stalker.
Oh, no.
Don't be a stalker. And if you do,
stalkers.
And if you do, don't do what she did.
Don't get in the bathtub. Want to wear his blood.
Stay out of bathtubs and do not wear blood, whatever you do.
Wow.
It is Roy and Jimmy in the morning. Thanks for listening. We will be back, all three of us, Roy, Jimmy, Donna, tomorrow morning, 7 to 9, right here at chaoticradio.com. Everybody, have a good morning.
Have a great day.
We'll see you.